Hello students, and welcome to the quick solution of All India Cast Test Series JEE Advanced 2019 Test 3A Paper 1 Code C&D Physics. Let's move to question number 1. In question number 1, a coil made up of total length L of wire and having n number of turns. If it carries a current of I, then magnetic moment of the coil is. So the total length is L. So L is equal to, let the number of turns in the coil is n, and its radius is r, so I can write n into 2 pi r. So from here we get the value of r, that is equal to l divided by 2 pi n. Now the magnetic moment is equal to number of turns n, current I into a, that is pi into r square. So the value of r is l upon 2 pi n whole square. So if I solve this, it comes out to be I into L square divided by 4 pi n. So option C is correct. Let's move to question number 2. In question number 2, in the circuit shown in the figure, the steady state current in the coil of self inductance L1 after the switch S is closed is. So when the switch S is closed, then let at any time t, the current in this is I1 and the current in this is I2. Since the potential difference between these two points will remain same as well as across this inductor, so I can say that L1 into di1 by dt is equal to L2 into di2 by dt, or I can say that L1 into di1 is equal to L2 into di2, or if I integrate, L1 into i1 is equal to L2 into i2. So from here we get the relation that I is inversely proportional to L. Now in the steady state, the inductor coil will behave like a conducting wire. So in that case, the current I is equal to E by R. So we have to calculate the current through self inductance L1 in the steady state. So current I1 is equal to L2 divided by L1 plus L2 of I, that is E by R. So option C is the correct answer. Let's move to question number 3. In question number 3, a uniformly charged non-conducting ring of mass M and charge Q with radius R placed in XY plane is shown in figure. A uniform magnetic field BK cap exists in the region. If ring starts rotating with angular velocity omega is equal to minus 2QB by M K cap, then tension or compression developed in the ring is. So if I consider a small segment on this ring, let I have considered this element, and this element sustained an angle 2 delta theta at the center, then this angle is delta theta as well as this angle is delta theta. So the ring is rotating in this direction. So this charge is moving in this direction with velocity omega into r. Since the magnetic field is outward and the velocity of the element is in this direction, so the magnetic force experienced by the element is inward. Also, the component of the tension on the non-conducting ring also acts inward. So we can say that the required centripetal force is provided by the tension force as well as the magnetic force. So if I write the equation on this considered element, then I can say that Q, that is Q divided by 2 pi R into R2 delta theta, that is the charge on the element, into V, that is omega R into B, that is the magnetic force acting towards the center, plus component of tension, since the tension force on the considered element will act in this way. So if I take the component, then the net force towards the center due to tension will be T into 2 times delta theta, because delta theta is small, so sine delta theta can be written as delta theta. So that is the net force towards the center, and that is equal to dm, mass of the element, that is m divided by 2 pi r into 2 r delta theta into omega square into r, and the value of omega is given, that is 2 qb by. So if I substitute the value of omega in this equation and solve for t, then it comes out to be q square b square r divided by pi into m. So option B is the correct answer. Let's move to question number 4. In question number 4, radioactive nuclei of decay constant lambda is being formed by some other process with a constant rate k. If at t equal to 0, number of active nuclei is equal to 0, then find the total number of nuclei after time t. So, the rate of formation of radioactive nuclei at any time t can be written as dn by dt is equal to k minus lambda into n, where n is the number of radioactive nuclei at any time t. This differential equation can be written in this way, k minus lambda n is equal to dt. So at t equal to 0, the number of active nuclei is 0, and at any time t, the number of active nuclei is n. So if I solve this equation, then we will get n is equal to k by lambda into 1 minus e to the power minus lambda into t. So option A is the correct answer. Let's move to question number 5. In question number 5, two coherent waves produced at two different points at any time t are represented by y1 and y2 are superposed. Find the path difference x1 minus x2 to produce constructive interference. So in order to have constructive interference, the phase difference between the two waves must be equal to 2n pi. So I can write 2 pi x1 by lambda minus omega t plus pi by 6 minus of 2 pi x2 by lambda minus omega t plus pi by 8 must be equal to 2n pi. So if I solve this equation further, then I can write 2 pi by lambda into x1 minus x2 is equal to 2 pi into n minus 1 by 48. So if I solve this further, then the value of x1 minus x2 comes out to be lambda times n minus 1 by 48. So option B is the correct answer. Let's move to question number 6. In question number 6, the diameter of a cylinder is measured using a vernier caliper with no zero error. It is found that zero of the vernier scale lies between 6.20 cm and 6.25 cm of the main scale. It means that the least count of the main scale is equal to 0.05 cm. Further, it is given in the question, the vernier scale has 25 divisions equivalent to 1.30 cm. It means that one division of vernier scale is equal to 1.3 divided by 25. So if I solve this, it comes out to be 0.052 cm. So if I take the difference in these two readings, the difference will come out to be 0.002 cm. Since it is a regressive reading, so the final reading in order to find out the diameter of the cylinder can be written as 6.25 minus 0.002 into 40. So if I solve this, it comes out to be 6.222 cm. So option A is the correct answer. Let's move to the first paragraph containing question number 7, 8 and